I'm a happy guy. I like to do natural, optimistic thinking about the South. The South is one of my favorite topics. That's why I get dismayed when I see people who keep falling into that same trap of only wanting to talk about the years 1861 to 1865. Good grief, folks. There's 400 years of Southern culture to celebrate. Why do we keep limiting ourselves to just four of them? And my favorite topic is Southern music. Love talking about Southern music because my Yankee friends incorrectly refer to it as American music, but actually American music is Southern music. Think about it. Every genre of American music that you can name, almost everyone that you can think of is actually Southern. It doesn't matter. And it's actually almost not even fair. If the South had contributed four or five genres to American music, well, that would be one thing. But we contributed almost all of them. Think about it. Try to name some genres of American music. There's rock and roll. Well, that's Southern. How about jazz and blues? Southern. Country, bluegrass. Well, obviously, that's Southern. Rhythm and blues, soul, funk. Southern. Cajun, Tejano. Zydeco, Creole. Southern. Spiritual, gospel. Barbershop, Sacred Heart. All of them Southern. It doesn't matter. Whichever genres you can name that have an iconic American sound, they come from the South. I have identified 36 different, separate, significant genres of American music that are all Southern. And they didn't just pass through the South. They didn't just kind of glance off the edges of the South. They came from deep within Dixie. They were born in the belly of the beast of good, true, authentic Southern ingredients. Think about rock and roll, for example. Rock and roll is actually a blend of country music and rhythm and blues music, which are both Southern styles. Well, what about rhythm and blues? Rhythm and blues is jazz and blues and gospel mixed together. All three of those are Southern styles. And the exact same thing happens with bluegrass music or with Tejano music or with Cajun music. They are all blends of unique, iconic Southern ingredients to make that Southern sound. It doesn't matter how far back you go or how far out you go, you're going to be stepping into Southern ingredients everywhere you go. What about the subgenres? Jazz, for example, is a pretty big umbrella. I mean, that covers a lot of different styles of music. There's ragtime, there's boogie-woogie, there's swing, Dixieland. All four of those are actually Southern, too. So even when you get into the subgenres, you're getting into more Southern music. Southern music also could not have come from anywhere except the South. It's not like Britain was going to invent rock and roll and we just happened to beat them to it. Rock and roll can only come from the American South of the 1950s. Even though British musicians make pretty good rock musicians, Britain does not have native country music or native rhythm and blues music. It's not native to the British people, so they couldn't have invented rock and roll. Now, one of the most satisfying things to me about Southern music is that there is no Yankee alternative, or even worse, a Yankee replacement. Because trust me, if Yankees had music of their own, they would have shoved it down our throats a long time ago, and Southern music would be extinct by now. But they got nothing. So that's why we get to celebrate and flaunt Southern music every chance we get. Yankees make that same mistake with music that they make with everything else, and that's try to divide it up into black and white. They don't see Southern music. They see black music, they see white music. And that's not accurate. It's Southern music. It's cross-cultural Southern music. Think about a plate of food. If someone has a plate of greens, black-eyed peas, and cornbread, a Yankee would look at that plate and say, oh, well, that's black food. That's soul food right there. No, to us, that's not soul food. That's Southern food. That's our food. We all eat that. It's a cross-cultural experience that we all enjoy. Music is the exact same thing in the South. It's not black. It's not white. It's Southern music. It's our music. Southern music is created from a collaboration, cooperation, and definitely mutual respect of the musicians. Yankees are really good at dividing things into categories and groups. Southerners are really good at seeing people as people. And that's what makes our music so fantastic and so great. It's the music and it's the people. And that's why I love talking about Southern music. My name is Tom Daniel for the Abbeville Institute.
bitter.